The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from San Juan, Puerto Rico, weighing in at 173 pounds, the Rebel, Gabriel.
He may have started his career in Hollywood, but grew up in a household where Throwback Thursdays meant watching his parents' WWE VHS tapes.
Hey, it's great to grow up a fan, but when you play rough, you get hurt. One wrong move here, and his night's over.
Big time match for the Hitman.
And his opponent, representing the Hart Foundation, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 235 pounds, Brett the Hitman Hart!
Saxton, you should be standing up and applauding that the Hitman has graced us with his presence.
Corey, can you believe that Bret Hart made his pay-per-view debut at WrestleMania 2?
Of course I can believe it. I can believe that Bret Hart's a national hero, whereas you, Byron, aren't even a hero in your own house.
You don't know that.
Looking into the eyes of this competitor tonight, you know he understands the significance of this match. This is an opportunity to make big headway on the roster.
We've got Canada's favorite son on the other side. There's no question Hart's an elite strategist, but will the Hitman be able to carry out his plan as he devised it? Or is he gonna have to make adjustments during the course of the match?
I seriously doubt Bret is having any feelings of distress, Corey. Hart is so versatile that calling an audible is second nature to him. He's staring his opponent down, getting into that zone.
And that failed to hit the mark.
Oh, solid kick across the back.
Sent into the corner.
Oh, strong knee connects.
Hart just can't stop this attack.
The Hitman is showing some vulnerabilities in his game. Kick right to the face. Trying to find his bearings, but it looks like his end is near.
From the Kinshasa.
Mounted with punches and not, oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
Looks like he has the upper hand now.
This is what he feeds off of.
Tremendous pressure on the head and neck.
A beautiful body scissors into a cover.
Wow.
One, two.
How in the world did he kick out?
Turn out the lights just yet.
Oh, look at this. He's got it locked in.
He made up. He let it go.
Yeah, I wonder why. Hart gets out of there.
Lariat. Good Lord.
That was nasty. Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
Oh, heinous knee to the face.
He's looking a little weary now.
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing now.
And oh my God, what a forearm!
Right to the jaw.
Knee right to the face.
Unloads with the boot.
Up into the torture rack.
Good time to capitalize on Bret.
This letting him free,
had him where he wanted him, but maybe he has something better planned.
Sudden cutoff from Bret.
Oh. He saw that one coming.
Nasty right hand.
Vicious enziguri.
Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here? Gets put into the barricade.
Two.
And a big boot. Bret is not finding a way to gain the edge.
Three. The Hitman unable to use his wide arsenal here.
Climbs back into the ring.
The sleeper is cinched in, and you can see little by little the opponent is fading.
Oh, just tap out. Just tap out and end this thing.
Losing this match would absolutely destroy him. He's trying to fight it.
In trouble here?
Oh, what a great counter. That'll break it up. And Bret gets countered.
Maybe he's found a new source of aggression to battle back with.
Every ounce of momentum is now against him.
He can't just think of riding this out. He has to get on offense.
Yes.
The sound of this crowd is deafening, and he's asking for more.
Oh, he retaliates.
Perched on the shoulders.
Oh, feast your eyes.
That puts him in total control.
Guys, no contest.
As always, Cole, you're more polite than I am, so I'll just say what we're all thinking. This was as one-sided as it gets.
The following contest is a handicap match. Making his way to the ring from San Juan, Puerto Rico, weighing in at 173 pounds, the Rebel, King.
He knows there's no stunt, man. There are no do-overs. This is live. This is in your face, and you only get one shot at glory once the bell rings.
He went from a sound studio to this packed arena, but his goal remains the same, to be the best.
From Miami, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, The Rock!
Well, here's a man who's captured the imagination of the entire sports entertainment industry, the Brahma Bull, one of the very best of all time.
Without question, The Rock has been a champion at every level.
Hey, Saxton, your role? Know it. Your mouth? Shut it.
That wasn't very nice. It is just such an incredible moment every time The Rock competes.
Desire to be the best ever has been fulfilled. The Great One possesses amazing agility, power, and stamina.
The Brahma Bull looks set to run over the competition here tonight.
The leader of the Attitude Era, the Rattlesnake.
The biggest anti-hero in WWE history.
And from Victoria, Texas, weighing in at 252 pounds, Stone Cold Steve Austin!
Corey, give me a heck yeah!
No, you dork. You're why Austin invented the what chance?
What does that mean?
It's exactly what you think it means, you derelict.
I just don't understand why a superstar would accept a match in which they're outnumbered. I mean, confidence is one thing, but recklessness is another.
WWE is reckless, if nothing else, Michael. You should know that by now. Besides, there's usually a good reason to sanction such a match.
I'm not so sure of that in this match, but we'll find out.
Boom! A forearm smash! Wow!
He went right into that turnbuckle.
Sharp knee.
Boom! It's okay, they weren't that pretty anyway.
Look at this.
Destructive arm breaker.
The Rock may be in a bad way here.
Can break an arm. The Rock hoping to head this attack off at the pass.
An unfamiliar spot for the Great One.
Uh-oh, not a good place to be.
Series of kicks in the corner.
Foot meet face.
Oh, what a forearm.
by the Great One.
Driven face first.
Out of the way in time.
Had that move from The Rock scouted.
It's the revolving door. Forearms.
Ouch.
Rolling elbow right on the mark. Perched on the shoulders.
Oh!
Feast your eyes. The Great One is down. The Rock is down.
And they're still in this.
Oh!
Knee right to the face.
Oh!
Knee strike connects. Sliding back in.
Three.
He's got to know he's in harm's way here.
Lift off.
Diving forearm smash. It's demoralizing to see The Rock in trouble here.
The Rock is not looking good here.
Body scissor takedown.
Into the cover.
Rope break. Head stop.
This is getting intense. Someone check on Saxton.
Wow.
Nasty knee.
The Rock saw that one coming.
But Rock has to keep the pedal at full throttle while he has the opening.
Great counter!
Rock looking far from great right now. Big opportunity to beat the Great One.
Perched on the shoulders. Feast your eyes.
That might be the final nail in the coffin.
Makes the cover.
Two.
Tonight. A well-earned victory here tonight.
To quote a pair of awesome scholars, in life, there are winners and there are losers. We are looking at a winner right now.
Hey, glad you made it. I'm Baron Blade. Whatever you've heard about me, don't believe it. Unless it was good, then it's totally legit. So you two ready for the big show tonight?
Yeah, can't wait to check out all the matches.
I'm sure you'll be able to watch from the back a bit, but I don't allow wrestlers in the audience. Unless it's a lighthouse and we need to beef up the head count, but that's not the case for tonight. Especially after we blew up on social media, saying two future WWE superstars were competing.
Wait, are you saying we're in a match?
Yeah, I sent Chase a message about it. It said, bring a friend to the show, need more matches.
Chase, what the heck, man?
To be fair, the one other time we met, you talked nonstop about how much you loved collecting matches from restaurants you ate at. So I guess me bringing some from several different local establishments was a complete waste of time.
Oh, no, I'll still take those. Thanks.
This is exactly what I was afraid of. I didn't want anyone to know we were here, and now we're going to wrestle?
Not my problem. And like I said, it's already out there on social media, so you might as well go through with it anyway. You should probably go get changed into your gear, though.
I don't have any gear. I thought we were just here to watch the show, remember?
Oh, come on, man. You always bring your gear. Rookie mistake. Just wrestle in your clothes, I guess.
Remind me to never listen to you again.
How would I be able to remind you if you're not gonna listen to me again?
You're the worst.
Well, look who it is, the two hottest stars on the indies.
I guess you saw what happened.
I'm certainly not an expert on the old internets, but it was kind of hard not to see it. Footage was plastered all over social media.
What'd you think of the match? 4 stars? 5, maybe?
That's not really important right now. What matters is I wasn't the only one who got wind of your little guest appearance. You know, they do have internet up in Connecticut, right? Here's what I'm thinking. First time offense, your sentence is a crap ton of cardio, and then a match against the Viking Raiders. Sound fair?
Yes, that's more than fair. And I promise, it won't happen again.
It better not, or you two will permanently be on the indies. Now go do laps around the building until the Viking Raiders get here.
When might that be?
Oh, about 3 hours from now. Go.
Oh.
Hey, we have some good news.
You're not going to have to deal with us much longer.
Well, maybe if everything works out.
What do you mean?
Triple H feels like he's seen enough from you and the rest of the class. So it's time for an official evaluation.
Is this the PC showcase you mentioned back on my first day?
Exactly. All of the GMs will be here to see you guys in action. If you impress any of them enough, you might receive a contract offer.
Thanks for helping me get to this point. I won't let you down.
You put in the hard work and earned this opportunity. Now it's time to deliver and reap the benefits.
I'll be ready.
We should also mention that each GM is going to be accompanied by a superstar from their brand to help evaluate you guys.
And by evaluate, I mean you're going to face one of the visiting superstars. We already know how you do against the other guys here, so we wanted to give you a new challenge.
That all sounds good to me. So who will I face?
Well, the options are Oney Lorcan from NXT, Shinsuke Nakamura from SmackDown, or the toughest challenge out of the three, Drew McIntyre from Raw.
Keep in mind, there's no wrong choice. But being a tougher opponent would be more impressive to the GMs, potentially open more doors. But if you lost, risk might not be worth it.
So, now that you've had 10 seconds to consider this life-altering decision, what's it gonna be?
I want to really impress the GMs. Give me Drew McIntyre.
All right, we'll make it happen. Good luck, kid.
Wait, we almost forgot the best part. There's a little surprise waiting in your locker.
Oh, you mean his custom gear we made for him.
Well, now that the cat's out of the bag, remember your first day when you designed your wrestling attire? Well, we figured it might help your chances if the GMs could see how you'd really look in WWE.
Unless you'd rather stick with your plain old boring training gear.
No. I think I'm gonna go with my custom look. Thanks, guys.
Just a heads up, I wouldn't get all worked up about this PC showcase, since the GMs are really only coming to scout me.
That's not what I've heard. Who are you gonna face anyway?
I'm taking on the mascot. I'll dominate him and show the GMs what they've been missing out on.
Wait, so you're not even facing one of the visiting superstars? Sounds like someone is scared to lose in front of the GMs.
It's called being smart and putting myself in the best position to succeed. Maybe you should try it sometime. But good luck getting...
I am so jacked for this PC showcase. I had a dream last night that I beat Paragon and was signed by Mandy Rose to Raw. But man, the dream got crazy. But we don't need to get into that.
You beating Paragon and getting signed to Raw wasn't the crazy part.
Oh, no way, man. I can do this. I step up my game when the pressure's on. And besides, all I need is one shot.
Well, I admire your confidence. And I hope it works out that way.
Maybe we'll end up on the same show. That'd be sweet. Could even ride together, live together, work out together, eat together.
I know. We could do a lot of things together.
All right, well, good luck in your match. I'm gonna go buy a new suit to impress the GMs, specifically Mandy Rose. If our real-life connection is anything like it was in my dream, there's gonna be fireworks when we meet.
Yeah, I get it, Chase. Good luck with all that.
I've heard a lot about you, and you didn't disappoint with your win over Drew McIntyre today. With that being said, I'd like to offer you the opportunity to sign with NXT.
It would be an honor. In my opinion, NXT is the top brand in WWE, and I'm only going to help make it stronger.
I'm betting on that. And don't forget to take a moment to celebrate this achievement. You've earned it.
Thank you, Mr. Regal. I promise you won't be disappointed with your decision.
I hope not, but we'll find out soon enough.
You're looking at the Blue Brand's newest superstar. It took longer than it should have, but finally, I'm gonna show the WWE Universe what the rest of the world already knows. When it comes to wrestling, I am the paragon.
Good for you. I'm gonna do the same thing in NXT, but without the lame nickname.
Whatever. I'd say I'll be watching you on NXT, but I'll be too busy dominating SmackDown. But if you ever make it out of the minors, let me know.
Hey, I heard you're going to NXT. Looks like I'll have some company.
You signed with NXT too?
Yeah, I just spoke with Regal. I think it's a great fit for my style, and I'll be able to compete for the Cruiserweight Championship. We should look out for each other there.
That's a good idea, especially considering we might have targets on our backs coming in as the new guys.
Look forward to competing with you there. Congrats, man.
You too.
Heard you got signed. Congrats.
Thanks. What's the matter with you?
What's the matter? You and Hector and Paragon all got signed, but no one wanted me, and now I'm stuck here while you guys are all moving on to bigger and better things.
Comparing yourself to us isn't going to help. Your time will come, trust me. You just need to take a hard look in the mirror and see what you can change to capitalize on the next opportunity that comes along.
That's good advice. But what if it wasn't anything that I did wrong? What if someone in WWE doesn't want me to succeed? What if I'm being held down?
Bro, I think you've been spending too much time on social media. There are no conspiracy theories in play here.
All right, but that is exactly what you would say if there was one.
Chase, keep your head up and continue to work hard. I gotta go clean up my locker.
That's not code, is it? Like you're not trying to tell me there's a conspiracy theory against me? That I'm being locked down?
Wink, Chase.
Congrats on getting signed to NXT. I think you're gonna do big things there.
Thanks for saying that, especially since we haven't always seen eye to eye.
It's hard for me to see eye to eye with anyone these days. That's a joke. But nonetheless, this is always a proud day for us. But just remember, don't slip up and embarrass me or the other coaches, okay?
So basically, don't do anything you would have done when you were starting out in WWE.
Exactly. Good luck, kid. I'll be watching.